Hello everyone, and welcome back to Wicked Art. It's Wicked here, and it is Wicked Wednesday. Like I said in my other videos this week, I'm a little on a Batman kick, so I'm gonna do a creepy Batman image. And I was having a little debate of like, oh, maybe I should do Scarecrow or a creepy Joker, and then it hit me. What is the creepiest thing in all of Batman, and it does not get creepier than the Batman who laughs. Alright? So, you need a pencil and an eraser, and we are gonna get started with this very creepy image. Okay? So, I'm gonna start, like usual. I'm gonna start with a circle. Okay, so I'm gonna build his head out first. Okay? So now that I have that, I wanna get my line that comes down the middle. Alright, because we want to. This character has a very long face because, and the reason why he is called the Batman Who Laughs, as he is a hybrid of Batman and Joker from the Dark Universe. Okay, so like the counterpart to Batman and what he would be in this dark, creepy universe. Okay? So, fair warning, this is a creepy character. Okay, so if you are somebody who's young and gets easily creeped out, this may not be the video for you. Okay, now we do have a little bit of an easier take. Okay, so first thing we have is our head, right? So I'm going to come back and kind of run this almost to a point. Okay, I want it to be very angular. Okay, so when I come out this way, I can curve up and get my ears, my bat ears. Okay, so I'm going to bring that down into the head. I'm just going to leave that there for now. Okay, and then we're going to come on this side of the head. I'm going to kind of come out a little bit first. Curve that up. Cool part is it's a little bit easier because this Batman does not show his eyes, so we don't have to worry about drawing the eyes. And but he does have this very creepy I'm not even sure what you'd call it. It's like a large bar or like a flat piece of metal that goes across his face. And it's got spikes on it. So again, a very creepy image, and for you younger viewers, you may not know this, but some older ones you might, kind of gives me that, bit of a heck razor vibe. I don't know if I'm allowed to actually say the other one, so, but yes, heck razor. Who knows, maybe it'll be something you can check out when you're older, or some of you watching this might already be old enough to see it. But that's neither here nor there. Okay. Now that this is drawn out, I need to straighten this. Okay, and then I can use the edge here to help me connect my ears a little bit better on this side. So I can actually bring this up a little bit more. Let's make it a little thicker on this side. Okay. So we can erase that line there. Alright. So now we can come in here and get these spikes. Now the creepy part is where the spikes are located. almost look like they're jutting from his eyes to begin with. Okay. So we have that there. I'm just going to draw me a line connecting to the top there. And then we'll do another one on this side. So you can really honestly, and remember, pause the video if you need to. Or honestly, just, you can make these spikes however you wish them to look. Or position them. Wherever. But, you know, just as long as they are wrapping around his head. Now I kind of messed up a little bit, so need to redo that. And again, another line. Down from the top. Okay. And now I can come over, get another one in, because yes, these spikes just wrap right around his head. Okay, so I will erase that. See a little bit of the bottom there. Okay, so it should be a very fine line between the bottom and the top. Okay. Alright, and then we're going to come to this other side here. And we're going to draw another one this way. Now, since this one's facing away a little bit, it won't be quite as long. We'll see a little bit more at the bottom on that one. Okay. So we got a nice little spike in there. Okay, and then we can see one more. We'll try to squeeze in here. That's kind of wrapping around towards the back. Just like that. And then we'll do one more back here. Have that come out. Like I said, on Wicked Wednesdays, we try to do some wicked pictures. And like I said, this is the creepiest thing I could think of. Now, we are going to see, from the center, we're going to see a little bit of the cowl, right in here, okay. Now, I can go ahead and erase that part out, okay, and now we get to the creepy part, okay, and we're going to make some adjustments to our face here. Just because it's that Joker smile. Alright, so we're gonna kinda come back this way. Curve. We're gonna come out. And then we are going to come down here, and we will just use this. Inside of the mouth, and then kind of have the rest of the lip on this side. So let's bring that over. Let me erase that, fix that. Okay, so we want that kind of come over. The mouth can connect there. Later, but what I'm going to do to help me with that is I'm going to go ahead and we're going to build in these teeth. Okay, that's probably the creepiest part about this character, is having this exaggerated Joker mouth. gum lines to show. So I'm just gonna draw his teeth back. And I'm just gonna go side to side just to help keep it even. Just remember though, if you need to, feel free to pause the video. Okay, so right now it just looks like we kind of have floating teeth, and that's okay. The rest will fill in as we go. Okay, and obviously we'll be drawing this in my style, so I like to, again, I like to leave things open so you guys can color it and add more detail to it as you see fit. Okay, so I'm gonna add another tooth right in here, and then we'll squeeze in one more. Squeeze in one more right here. Okay. So I'll connect that to the mouth there. And then I can come back on this side. And I can just continue back. Again, you can do subtle shifts in positioning to kind of show some variation in the teeth. So see how I've really turned that one? That is so I can really separate these two here. And we will just continue to work our way back. So like I said, he has a very big smile. Okay, so we have that gum line there. Now comes the tricky part, okay? So his teeth are really kind of messed up, so we're gonna draw a little bit with like some gappage in mind just to add that extra creep factor to it. Okay, so a little bit of a split in the teeth ain't gonna hurt. Just kind of sell the creepiness a little bit. So I can just darken that up, show a space, and come down, and come back up. So I'm just continuing this teeth, you know, tooth shape pattern, going back, and we are just going to continue. Tell you what, let's bring this next one up. Taller. Then kind of curve it back skinny. Okay, so it's going to have a lot of jagged, crooked teeth on this bottom area here. Okay. So now that I have that, I'm going to do a couple more on this side. I want to go ahead and come from this area with the gums just so I can see about where I need to stop. So erase that line back. Okay. And then I'm going to add another tooth here. So with that knowledge, we can now erase here, and this will be like, so if that's my gum line coming up there, we need to kind of start bringing that lip line down. So where this kind of curves back here, I'm going to round in. let's go right here. Okay. So I want to come under. I want to make sure he's got a big gum line here. So we'll curve that this way, like that. And then I'm going to go ahead and get rid of that for now. Okay. So, next, I'm going to continue with our teeth on this side. Give him a really crooked tooth there. Maybe we can split off and come a little bit taller on this side. Like that. Okay. So now, over. Go down like that, and then we're going to do a big jump here. So we gotta start getting it to turn right towards the mouth. We'll do that there. So looking at that, let's come around this way. Actually, let's do this. Let's just erase those teeth back. It's probably better if we just finish out the jawline because it's starting to look a little on the crooked side. So let's start up here at this tooth here. Okay. We're going to kind of imagine that there. And then back here we have our gum line. We got our face. So I'm going to have my lip start to come down, kind of curve out a little, and go that way. So that means I really need my teeth to turn more. Going this way. Make more sense once we fill that in. Okay, so I want to come out here with my face. Okay. And then from here, we can kind of bring that lip out like this. This face is almost very scarred, I guess would be a good word for it. Alright, so we got some line work there. We'll bring this in this way. And come to about here. And then we'll bring that lip around here. Okay. So now I can take this face line here and then come down this way, bring in that jaw. Okay, so I'm really just working out almost that mangled chin shape here. Okay. So let's come back out. Come this way, and then come out from here. A couple little lines right in here. And we can bring that out this way. Actually, let's just come from right here so we don't go too far. Just shorten that right off the face here. Just like that. So you can see how creepy of a character he is. Right? And then just to break it up some, so when you guys go to shade or color, it's got a little bit more to it. I'm gonna draw his. He's got like a big, almost like a trench coat collar. So same shape. So let's have it turn this way. Okay. So first thing I am going to do is, because I really want these this mouth and these teeth to stick out, so I am gonna color in. And if you're gonna do yours in marker or colored pencil, you can go ahead and use that now. That's what you're wanting to do. Just color it in. But I'm just gonna color it in black with my actual pencil. So see, I'm just filling that in. Solid black. You just really want the teeth to stand out. Is what you're going for. Okay. So I'm just going to continue back. Now, if I was to color this or, you know, paint it, you'd get kind of the full effect of his creepiness. Just imagine him with that Joker, white paint. Okay, so I'm going to kind of go around the gums. I'm going to thicken that up just so we have a little bit of separation there. Now, we can put little lines in here, and just for like little metallic scratches on the surface. Okay, now I do want, let's go ahead and refine this upper line. And then I do want to come from there. I want to give that a top edge because he is, you know, kind of looking down at us. Or not at us, but, you know, looking down. Okay. So I am going to bring this up, but then I'm going to erase that part out right there. Okay. So I'm just going to go around. Darken everything up so it's not so sketchy anymore. So like this was really sketchy in here, so we want to really have a nice refined shape. So just just make sure you clean up any areas that look kind of, lack of a better term, dirty, or, you know, not very refined. Okay, so. Definitely a creepy character. If, let's say, Batman was ever to succumb to the Joker's beckons of always, you know, asking him to join, you know, him and be like him, that they were the same. This would be if that were true, and he gave in. Definitely a very dark and creepy character. Okay. Again, go in here and refine these lines because they're very faded. Most of that is honestly probably of my hand gliding across the paper, so a little art tip if you want to prevent that natural smudging that happens from your hand moving across the paper. You can get a paper towel or a tissue or just another piece of paper and just go across it that way. Now if you notice, I'm not too much touching up the edge because we are almost finished and I'm going to do my little, you know, trademark thing of darkening up the edges. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and start doing that. I'm going to thicken up the edge. Work my way around. Now this side's inside, so I do want to make sure that's refined. Of it. You're just going to go around and make it pop. This area. Just fall it around to his cowl ears up here. So, we're almost done. Like I said, I hope you managed to learn something from today. I hope this image wasn't, you know, too creepy for some of you. But, like I said, since I'm on my little Batman kick, let's thin this line out. I think that's a little too thick. I just figured, who better to do it with than the Batman who laughs. Okay, so I'm just gonna continue. Almost done. Like I said, I hope you had fun. If you have suggestions of like maybe a cryptid creature or, you know, something like my Pokemon turned into monsters ideas, just let me know. Leave a message down in the comment. I will take that into consideration for sure. just refine these lines in here. Okay, I'm gonna go back over some of these. Alright, and that is gonna do it for our Wicked Wednesday video. I hope you learned something, hope you had fun. And until next time, keep sketching, and I will see you in the next one. Alright? Bye.